Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key on your video player.
Good afternoon, all. Ira Epstein of Linn Associates with your agriculture update for this Tuesday, and we are now at the 15th of May, 2018, and the time just after 4 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Now, I want to remind you all before I get anywhere into this that we're going to hold our live webinar this coming Thursday. That is May 17th at 12:30 p.m. Central Daylight Time. The invites have gone out. If you didn't get one, call my staff at this number, 866-973-2077. They'll be able to send you one out, register, and away you go. There is no cost to it, obviously, but the beauty is we cover so much. You can bring in your questions. We'll cover charts with you. We'll try to get everything done that you want, and typically allow yourself, if you stay the whole time, about 40 minutes or so, but you can drop in, drop out as you'd want. You're going to need a password. The password comes in the invite and the confirmation. It's in two areas. The charts will look like this, and we'll discuss everything your heart desires, okay? So let's talk about the markets. In the grains, we were an update. We went down as low as 10.05, and the beans came bouncing back up. You know, the Chinese delegation is in America. Maybe we'll get something done. I frankly don't know. Wheat up a little bit, and corn was a surprise. I thought it would stop at the 18-day average of closes. It went a little beyond that. Let's take a look at what we've got. In the beans, we went down from 10.54 and a quarter to the most recent low last week, which was 9.93 and a quarter, settling near the lows at 9.94 and three quarters. We've now bounced back up 24 cents in 2 days, knocking on the door of the 18-week moving average of closes, as displayed in the red right here. So that should be the resistance around the 10.22 level. We had what's called an outside day up yesterday, and today we had an inside day. We didn't take out yesterday's highs or lows. Now, what does that do on the pattern? Well, if you can see what it's been doing here, you went from the low up to the high. You've still got the pattern of lower highs, lower lows, so that's bearish. When I put on the 18-day average of closes on the chart, and the 100-day, you're narrowing into just what we talked about. If you're going to get a rally, this could be the resistance point in the market, dropping down. And by the way, the 18-day average is now under this last rally high, and it's going to drop further tonight. It's dropping on average, if I can get this to move for us, about 2 cents a day. Do you see that? 10.36 here, 10.34. 10.32. So each day about that. So it should drop down very close to where the 100-day average is. So that's the resistance zone that I'm looking for. If the market gets over 10.33 and three quarters, this leg of the downtrend I have to pronounce done, sealed, delivered. In terms of Bollinger Bands, that's this black dashed line, the market's done its job of hitting it, bouncing away, hitting it, bouncing away. That's all that I could say it's doing. And when I look at momentum, the market has now got both numbers under, or are they, under 20? They're not. We just have an oversold condition. So you have an oversold market that's hit downside targets, rallying back into projected resistance area. Should it take out 10.33 and three quarters, I would say that the bear leg of this move that just finished off here is over. Doesn't mean it is yet. In the meal market, should you take out today's low, be careful. You could then have lower highs, lower lows, which you've got anyways, and you start targeting this area. If the market's going to do anything positive, I want you to notice that it's almost every single day you're hitting that 18-day average. This market is looking for direction right now, and that's why I said if it can take out today's lows, it might pick that up. At the same time, the difficulty in getting short this market is you'd be selling into an oversold condition. In the soybean oil, We talked yesterday, and I think one of the things I said, I know I said it in my morning videos, and I'm talking my subscriber video, was after this big run-up, the market had so many days in a row up, it was just probably due for something of a pullback. And that pullback, I would think, would stop near that 18-day average. You missed it by four ticks today, but I'll call that in the ballpark. You're an overbought market that is not trending. You got a lower low and a higher high. Yes, the bias is up since you're over the 18-day average, but momentum is overbought. Not a good trade there. Corn, as I said earlier, surprised me. I did not expect the market to get so easily back over that 18-day average of closes. Now, momentum has stalled. You can see that right here, but it has not turned up. The bias turned up when you closed over the 18-day average, but the trend is down. If you can take out 394 and a quarter, you could start another leg to the downside and possibly get here. If the market gets up over 407, it negates this swing down and puts you nowhere. You'd then have a lower low and a higher high. So sort of a difficult position right now. In the wheat market, we've had an extended break, one that has gone from 537 rather, as low as 486 and a quarter today, and the market with that was able to close a little bit higher. It made a run for the 100-day average, but so far hasn't been able to get to it, and it is very oversold. Again, not a trend. Higher high, lower low. In the sugar market, the market's trying to bottom out here. Now, if you believe that momentum turns before price, the momentum of this market turned up today. Yes, the market is still in a downtrend, and admittedly, every failure has taken place since almost February against this 18-day average, so I'm definitely suspect. But if you take out 1159, you will start rounding the Bollinger Bands. You will have broken the pattern of lower highs, lower lows. Already today, you did close with an 1152 over the 18-day average, and taking out 1159 will take away that pattern of lower highs, lower lows. Is anything here bullish yet? No, but a bottom could be forming in the market. In the coffee market, my eye immediately goes to an oversold market that is clearly in a downtrend, lower highs, lower lows. Will it be able to get far enough down here to hit the lower Bollinger Band is a question. It's about 100 points away. It doesn't have to, given how oversold it is. In the cocoa market, we're starting to round out. We have a higher high, lower low, back under the lower Bollinger Band coming out of sideways action. Admittedly, this market is oversold. Most of the grains are priced in dollars, obviously, and soft commodities. So the rising dollar getting to these highs that we haven't seen in many years is definitely going to take its toll on some of the exports that go on in U.S. dollars. In the cotton market, was that it? I don't know. You're oversold. Seem to be stuck at the 18-day average of closes. If you get over 84.90, you negate this leg of the downtrend. But once again, because this low today of 83.36 took out the previous low of 83.50, it can't start an uptrend. What's the common theme? The break in the markets has gotten oversold in a number of them. In the cattle market, you fell back to the lower Bollinger Band, where I would expect to see some support develop. We've gone in basically 3 days from the upper Bollinger Band to the lower band. We ended the uptrend when the market, and right here, when this low was taken out, 104.97, and that was yesterday, and now the market's following through the lower band as momentum turned down, and that's where I think you're at. Your market's looking for direction in very much a sideways action out of its uptrend. Feeder cattle, different story. Fundamentally, we've had a lot of cattle put into the feedlots. That was a theme all fall and winter. Not fall, I said that wrong. All coming out of winter into spring, I said that wrong. And I don't think those animals are quite gone yet. Yes, the weather's milder. Yes, certain parts of it, you're going to do some grass feeding and so on. But you still got plenty of animals, and you're seeing that in the chart there. And in the hog market, the one-day rally we had with hopes that maybe hogs wouldn't get tariffs put on them the way that we at first thought, well, you made back what you gained. Yesterday you were up 105, today you're down 142. So that idea didn't last very long. Notice the battleground, 18-day average of closes. The trend is up, higher lows, higher highs, but the close under the 18-day average puts the bias down, and momentum is trying to turn down in this market as well. Again, if you want to come to our chat room, and let's call it a live chat room, because you're going to be able to chat with me and I'll be talking back to you, and it gets to be a lot of fun. You can click right up here at any time, and what will happen is that'll take you, if you're watching me on YouTube or any of those, right to the registration form. Otherwise, it's www.iraepstein.com/webinar. Got it? Pretty simple. I'll see you tomorrow.